Are there other things that we have? There are several types of picture. So let us go to the next one. The next one is what? Bulbs. There are bulbs. We have several types of bulbs. Heat bulbs, globe bulbs, right? Heat bulbs, globe bulbs. Actually, faucet is a type of bulb. Faucet is a type of bulb. So, right? Bulbs. Heat bulbs, globe bulbs. Those are the most common types of bulbs. There are other types of bulbs. Even whose beam is a type of bulb, actually. Faucet. So, set of bulbs, relief bulbs. Those are other types of bulbs. Set of relief bulbs. There are several types of bulbs. So, if you have this one, you can now create a basic plumbing system. And we will connect, and therefore, we will decide. Okay? We also have clients and equipment. Meaning to say, it includes appurtenances. I already told you what is the difference between equipment and device, or appliance and appurtenances, okay? When we say appurtenance, what does that mean? Okay? When we say appliance, what do we mean? We already detailed the difference. There are several things that we already mentioned previously. For example, sewage and sewerage, okay? Building drains and building sewer and building drain. What is the difference? Right? So we already know that. What else? There are several things that you will get confused of. So we already tackled those things. So appliance, and so there are many more types of this. For example, washing machine is an appliance. The hot and cold water dispenser are appliance, right? Particularly when the dispenser is having a water supply coming from the plumbing system, not from the but from the container, right? For example, fountain can be an appliance if the fountain has a function of hot and cold. It's an appliance, but it is an appurtenance if the fountain is having the ambient temperature, no need for what? Electric supply. For example, in the Philippines, we don't need a fountain with what? Electricity. However, there are hot countries, so we need what? Hot and cold function for fountains. So those are the different components involved in a plumbing system, and therefore in this chapter, in chapter 4, we are specifically looking at this one. Okay, so let us very briefly talk about the important data that you have to memorize. You have to memorize this. Okay? We will not one by one read the section and explain the section. We will, however, summarize and give you the data that must be memorized. Okay? For example, first, we found section 402 that we need gauge 16. No, gauge 16 or 1.6 mm thick. What? Material for use as what? Sink. Special use sink for restaurant kitchen. Okay? That is a minimum that must be approved by the duty official. So 1.6 mm thick. It is provided, no? The dimension is not by chance. It is indicated in the code. Okay? Next is section 404. And we have what? Connections for slip joint. What is slip joint in here? Slip joint is actually fitting. A type of fitting because it connects one component to a pipeline, okay? Slip joint. And the pipeline that is provided for connection of slip ring is how much? 0.3 meters. That is necessary, again, therefore, do not put anything within that area. No electricals, no other things within that area. That should be free from any obstruction, 0.3 meters. If we talk of 0.3, that is 1 foot in English units. Right, right, next. For continuous ways in fixture tailpiece. What is tailpiece? Tailpiece is a component usually found in a truck. And the most common and very important type of trap is P-trap. So P-trap has a component pipe that is called tailpiece. Okay? Tailpiece. The tailpiece should be constructed from material specified in chapter 14. However, it is to be gauge number 20 or 0.8 mm in thickness. Right? Very specific, 0.8 and gauge 20. Now, my first question is, if you are listening, what is the thickness of gauge 18? If you are listening, what is the thickness of gauge 18? Right? So, I already provided you with the information about gauge 16 and gauge 20. I am talking about what is the thickness of gauge 18. Alright, by simple algebra, do it to them.
Do it! Just do it! Don't let your dreams be dreams.
Those are the types of questions you will be encountering for example. But are those very easy to solve. However, if you don't know, you don't know. Okay? So it's such a tailpiece has supposed to be a diameter of 38 mm outside diameter. We are talking of outside, not the inside diameter, because we are having two types of diameter, inside diameter and outside diameter. So we are talking about of outside diameter. Tailpiece should have a diameter of 38 mm. If they are used for what? For sink, dishwasher, laundry, bathtub, urinals. And 32 mm outside diameter and for lavatories and drinking fountains. Right? So there are two types of tailpiece for drinking fountains and lavatories. One and one port and or 32 mm. And for others like sink, dishwasher, laundry, bathtubs, we have what? 38 mm. Okay? Take note of that data. All of this data will now be used in your design.